Hello, and welcome to another video in our series of Microsoft Office 365 Technical Support Modules. In this video, I'll show you how to troubleshoot problems with sign-in, conferencing, and audio-video quality in Microsoft Lync Mobile 2013 for Office 365. This video is for global administrators of Office 365 Enterprise, Office 365 Midsize Business, and Office 365 Small Business, including Office 365 Small Business Premium. However, some of the steps in this video can be performed by all users of Office 365. Microsoft Lync Mobile 2013 is available for Windows phones, iOS, and Android devices. Refer to the Microsoft TechNet article URL displayed on the screen for more information about Lync Mobile clients. First, I'll show you how to troubleshoot problems that users may experience when trying to sign in to Lync Mobile 2013. Users may experience the following errors when signing in to Lync Mobile. Now I'll show you a few steps to troubleshoot these errors. We're going to use the Windows Phone Lync Mobile 2013 client for demonstration purposes, but the experience is similar across different operating systems. First, users should make sure that the sign-in address and password are entered correctly. Click More Details and click Clear My Sign-in Info to remove cached server names and sign-in addresses. Users should re-enter their sign-in address and password carefully, ensuring that each key press is accurate. If the user's SIP address and UPN are the same, have the user enter their SIP address in the sign-in address field and leave the username field blank. If the user's SIP address and UPN are different, have the user enter their SIP address in the sign-in address field and their UPN in the username field. If users are still unable to sign in to Lync Mobile, they should switch between Wi-Fi and cellular data to determine if either of the connection types are causing the problems. Users should verify their internet connectivity by trying to visit websites such as Bing.com or Microsoft.com. Users who continue to experience errors should try to sign in to the desktop Lync client. If still unable to sign in, Office 365 Lync Online administrators should use the Microsoft Connectivity Analyzer to make sure that the necessary DNS records for Lync Online are configured. Refer to the Microsoft website URL displayed on the screen. Click the Office 365 tab. Select Office 365 Lync Domain Name Server's DNS Connectivity Test and click Next from the bottom of the page. Enter the sign-in address for the user experiencing the problems. Enter the verification code and click Verify. Click Perform Test from the bottom of the page. Problems with your configuration will be displayed when the diagnostics tests are completed. Expand each of the notes until you reach the root cause of each failure. For information on how to resolve each failure, click Tell me more about this issue and how to resolve it. Follow the instructions in the documentation to resolve your issue. You should also refer to the Microsoft Knowledge Base article URL displayed on the screen for more information about how to troubleshoot sign-in issues in the Lync Mobile client. Now I'll show you how to troubleshoot problems that you may experience when joining online meetings using Lync Mobile 2013. Users may experience the following issues when joining an online meeting using Lync Mobile. These issues may be caused by the following conditions. When the conference isn't found, it may have been canceled, or the user might not have permissions to join the meeting. Users may be disconnected when trying to join the meeting from multiple devices. If no meetings are listed on the meetings page in Lync Mobile 2013, the connection to the user's Exchange calendar could be down. Users may be disconnected for many reasons, including a lack of network connectivity. Bandwidth and network connectivity are the main causes of audio and video connection issues. Now let's go through a few steps to troubleshoot the problems. Try to join the meeting from the Lync Mobile 2013 meetings page. If that fails, try to join the meeting by using the Join URL from the meeting invitation. This tries to start the meeting through an internet browser. If the user connects to his or her mailbox with a set of credentials other than Lync, or if the user's mailbox is hosted in another environment, look under Exchange in the Lync Mobile 2013 settings, and then enter the correct credentials for the user's mailbox. Check the meeting in the Outlook calendar and try to join from a desktop client, if this is possible. Lastly, I'll show you how to troubleshoot poor audio and video connections using Lync Mobile 2013. In this section of the video, we discuss how to troubleshoot voice over IP, also known as VoIP for short, and video connections through Microsoft Lync Mobile 2013. We don't cover issues that occur when using Microsoft Lync Online together with Microsoft Lync to Phone Partner to dial out to your designated mobile number, also known as Call Via Work, or CVW for short. Users who are logged into Lync Mobile 2013 may experience issues when they try to make a VoIP or video calls over Wi-Fi or mobile data connections. Tapping Retry repeatedly does not resolve the problem, and the connection attempt is unsuccessful. Now let's talk about the troubleshooting steps you can follow to resolve these problems. If the user is on a mobile data connection, have the user switch to a Wi-Fi connection if available. Users should verify their internet connectivity by trying to visit websites such as Bing.com or Microsoft.com. Make sure that the bandwidth isn't limited and that other data-intensive applications work without any problems. If the user is on a corporate Wi-Fi connection that uses a proxy, the user may have to configure the HTTP proxy details in the Lync Mobile settings. Lync Online administrators should also make sure that the corporate firewall is configured correctly to allow necessary traffic in and out of the corporate network. Refer to the Microsoft Knowledge Base article URL displayed on the screen for more information on how to configure a corporate firewall for Lync Online connections. Make sure that only the required Wi-Fi or VoIP and video connection setting is selected in Lync Mobile. Finally, Lync Online administrators should make sure that the Lync Online users involved are allowed to make audio or video calls in the Lync Administration Center. Also, check the kind of contact that the Lync user is trying to communicate with. If the contact is from another Lync organization, or if it is logged in through Skype, audio or video conversations may be disabled. Refer to the Microsoft Help article URL displayed on the screen for more information on how to configure Lync Online settings for individual users. In this video, we showed you how to troubleshoot problems with sign-in, conferencing, and audio-video quality in Microsoft Lync Mobile 2013 for Office 365. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope that you found it helpful.